Hello friends, welcome to Global Online University. So friends, in this video I will discuss 250 most important MCQs for your paper 1 of teaching aptitude for UGC NET and SET examination. And for my Hindi language friends, I have also kept the question in Hindi, but I have discussed in English, so it won't be any problem because question is there for you in Hindi. And friends, I also recommend you to have a notebook and pen handy, so whenever a question appears, try to answer and note down all the important points which I am mentioning in the video. And I am convinced that if you watch this video till end, you should be able to answer at least 15 to 20 questions from your exam. If not the direct question, you should be able to solve the related question, because I have discussed every question in detail, every options I have discussed in detail. That's why I ask you to have a notebook and pen handy. And friends, if one more thing which I would like to stress is, watch this video now and do not forget to watch this video before your examination, just before your examination, so that will be your revision. Now without taking more of your time, I'll go to the questions. The question is, study of sign language is called. So friends, this question is related to the communication. Study of sign language is in communication system is called semiotics. And there are five theories of the studying non-verbal type of communication, of which space or distance, when it is studied in communication, it is proxemics. When it is about sign languages, it is semiotics. When it is about body language, it is kinesics. And when it is about touch, it is haptics. And when it is about time, it is called chronemics. So remember these five theories of non-verbal type of communication. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, validity and reliability of research will be at stake. So they have asked the validity or the authenticity of research will be in danger in which of the following condition, they have asked. So we'll go by one. First is, the author who is source of information is biased, incompetent and dishonest. So obviously here the authenticity of research will be at stake, because he is not honest, he is not unbiased and he is not competent. So it will be at stake. And in second case B, the incident was reported after a long period of time from that of its occurrence. So friends, this is also put authenticity of research at stake, because the lot of things change, because when it is reported in present and when it is reported in past, there will be lot of difference. C, the researcher himself is not competent enough to draw a logical conclusion. So this also will impact a research, this also impact the validity or authenticity of the research. So the correct answer will be all of the above. I hope you got your answer right. Next question. The question is, study of traffic signals, or the traffic signals are examples of which type of communication? So friends, in the first question we have seen the sign language, study of sign language is called semiotics. And here the traffic signals are also non-verbal type of communication. And study of sign, or say body language or touch or distance or space, it comes under non-verbal type of communication. So I hope you got it. The traffic signals are example of non-verbal type of communication. Moving on to the next question. The question is, in order to augment the accuracy of a study, a researcher. So friends, they have asked, how can a researcher increase the accuracy of his study? So option A, should increase the size of sample. So friends, this is correct. The bigger the sample size, bigger will be the accuracy. Should be honest and unbiased. Yes, this is also a prerequisite for accuracy of result, to increase the accuracy of result. Should keep the variance high, this is also right. So the correct answer will be all of these. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, a researcher want to study future of the Congress in India. So for the study, which tool is appropriate, most appropriate for him? So friends, if you know, the questionnaire is the most where you can have the broad audience or broad population via questionnaire. Schedule, interview or rating scale will not help, because questionnaire you will get all the data, all the your doubts, and it will reach to the many people, more people. If you share a Google spreadsheet these days or via any Facebook comment or anything, any social media. So this is the, for today's time, or the most appropriate of the all is questionnaire. So remember this, for case study questionnaire is the best. Now moving on to the next question. A field study is related to, so friends, field study is related to the real life situation where a researcher or any student goes in the real goes on the field to see the real life situation. The correct answer is real life situation. Now moving on to the next question. The question is, which state in India has highest number of state universities? So remember, highest number of state universities. So overall, the Rajasthan has more universities, but Uttar Pradesh has highest number of state universities. Moving on to the next question. Studying the social status of a population, a researcher concluded that Mr. X is socially backward. So we have to judge where his conclusion is wrong, right, inaccurate or biased. So friends, here if you see, from a population, the researcher has drawn a conclusion that Mr. X is socially backward. This comment is inaccurate because he has not compared it with another person. So if the statement is Mr. X is socially backward compared to Y, then this statement will be right. But now here, this is a half statement and this is inaccurate statement. So Mr. X is socially backward. If he has written that Mr. X is socially backward with compared to Y, then this will be right. But now this is inaccurate statement. So I hope you got it right. Move on to the next question. Next question is, customers coming to a mall, sharing some common interest and group based activities are steadily increasing. So which type of this example of which group? So here this is open group, because anyone can come to the mall and involve in those activities. So this is not peer to peer where you don't need any knowledge. This is not hierarchical because anyone can come. So as I said, this is open group. So the correct answer is open group. Now moving on to the next. The question is, sometimes mass media misleads society because receivers are. So friends, the biggest disadvantage of mass media is its audience is heterogeneous. They speak different language, they are from different age group, they are from they have different religion, they are from different region. So mass media audience is heterogeneous, that may sometimes mislead the society. Moving on to the next question. First question is, AICTE is responsible for proper planning and coordinated development of the. So they have asked the All India Council for Technical Education. So name itself is answer here. They are responsible for proper planning and coordinated development of technical education and management education. So correct answer will be A. And for medical education, we have Medical Council of India, that is MCI. For school education, we have different board like CBSE and different state board. And for distance education also, we have different board. But the technical distance education comes under UGC, and the technical education comes under AICTE. I hope you got it right. Moving on to the next question. Attitudes, actions and appearances in the context of classroom communication are considered as. So friends, if you are following our lecture, you might have got the idea that appearance, that is your dress code or your action and your attitude, they are examples of non-verbal communication. So the correct answer is non-verbal communication. Moving on to the next question. Photographs are not easy to. So friends, photographs are not easy to. So if you read the option, they are easy to publish, easy to secure and easy to change, but they are difficult to decode because there are too many pixels and each pixel has different image. So they are difficult to decode because of the more number of pixels. I hope you got it right. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, in a computer, a byte is generally consist of. So friends, we have already discussed that a byte is the smallest addressable unit of a memory in a computer, but one byte consists of 8 bits. So I hope you got it right. Moving on to the next question. Question is, unsolicited. So friends, unsolicited means not asked for voluntarily, or you don't want it, but it is there. An unsolicited email message sent to many recipients at once is called. So friends, when we receive most of the unsolicited, that unwanted messages, so we call them spam. There is a separate folder in an email that is a spam. So the correct answer is spam. Moving on to the next question. Next question is JPG, BMP, PNG are an extension for file which store. So friends, this is relatively easy. I hope everybody knows that it is. These are the extension for image data. Now moving on to the next question. Which of the following is not a search engine? So friends, if it comes to you that we generally use Google and Google Chrome, Yahoo, Bing, but friends, Chrome of them is not a search engine. It is a browser. Google is a search engine, Yahoo also is a search engine, and Bing also is a search engine. So remember, the Chrome is a browser. Okay, I hope you got it correct. Moving on to the next question. Sustainable development goals have a specific target to be achieved by. So friends, the sustainable development goals have a specific target to be achieved by year 2030. So the correct answer is they should be achieved by year 2030. Moving on to the next question. Which of the anthropogenic activities accounts for more than 2/3 of global water consumptions? So friends, the highest amount of global water consumption accounts for the agricultural, that is 2/3 of global water consumption. So I hope you got it right. Moving on to the next question. The question is, which of the following organization deals with the capacity building program on educational planning? So friends, the capacity building program is entrusted by UGC to the National University of Educational Planning and Administration. Remember, National University of Educational Planning and Administration, that is NUEPA, that National University of Educational Planning and Administration. The question is, imagine you are working in an educational institute where people are of equal status. Which of the following method of communication is best suited and normally employed in such a context? So friends, when people of different status exchange the message, it will be a vertical communication. When people of equal status exchange the message, it is horizontal communication. So in this case, the people are of equal status, so it will be a horizontal communication. Remember, horizontal communication, vertical communication, cross communication, corporate communication. Cross communication is people from the different region or completely different background, then it will be called cross communication. And in this case, the people of equal status, it will be called horizontal communication, and people of different status will be vertical communication. So the correct answer is horizontal communication. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following is not a renewable natural source? So friends, they have asked for the renewable natural source. So friends, the correct answer here is salt. You will sometimes may confuse how salt is a renewable, is not a renewable natural source, because it is generated. So friends, it is generated, but it is generated over the period of time. Like petroleum also we called is not a renewable natural sources. So same way, salt is also non-renewable natural source. So clean air, fresh water and fertile soil, they renew themselves. So the correct answer is salt. Moving on to the next question. So they have given a assertion and a reason, so we have to choose the correct code. The assertion is, people population control measure do not necessarily help in checking the environmental degradation. So this is an assertion. So this is correct, friends. There is no direct impact between population control measure and the environment degradation. So, and the relationship between population growth and environmental degradation is rather complex. So friends, this is also correct. So assertion is correct and reason is also correct. So the correct answer is both A and R are true, and R is correct explanation of A. So moving on to the next question. Next question is, a smart classroom is a teaching space which has. So first is smart portion with a touch panel control system. Yes, this is correct. PC, personal computer or a laptop connection and DVD or VCR player. Yes, this also correct. Document camera and specialized software. Yes, this also correct. And fourth is projector and screen. Yes, this all four are required for a smart classroom. So the correct answer will be 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, warrior is related to sword, carpenter is related to saw, and farmer is related to plow. And in the same way, the author will be related. So friends, here they have asked, so it is comparatively simple, I believe, because author is related to pen. So the correct answer will be pen. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, they have asked us to find the next number in the number series. So I think the today's mock test, this test is little bit easier. 2 and 5, the difference is 3, and 5 to 10 it is 5, then 5 to 17 it is 7, then 17 to 26 it is 9, then 26 to 37 11, and then next number, as you can guess, it should be more than 13. So it will be 50. So the correct answer is 50. Moving on to the next question. So in, so they have asked us, in certain code selection is coded as QCJCARGML. So friends, if you look at them, so every letter has -1, -2, I believe. Okay, so because S is written as Q and the last letter N is written as L. So L, M, N, and then first letter S is written as Q. So it will be like Q, R, S. So -2. So in this case, I should see the next thing. A, J, V, I, E, R, I, C, A, N, S. So friends, here A, if you do -2, so it will be X and Y. So the correct first letter should be Y and the last letter should be Q, R, S. So last letter should be Q. So in, we have option A where first letter is Y and second last letter is Q. So the correct answer will be 1. I hope you got it. This is very easy. If there is any problem, you can write in the comment section. Every communicator has to experience. So friends, every communicator has to experience anticipatory excitement. What is anticipatory excitement? Is a you try to feel anxious or you try to guess what audience will think. So that way, the every communicator has to experience anticipatory excitement. Moving on to the next question. Sampling cases means, so friends, sampling cases means sampling of people, newspapers, television programs. So the correct answer is sampling cases is 4. Moving on to the next question. Question is, which of the following are central universities? Pondicherry University, Vishwa Bharati, HNB, Garhwal University, and Kurukshetra University. Of these, Kurukshetra University is unitary university. All apart from that, 3 are central universities. So the correct answer is 1, 2, 3, option A. First question is, bibliography given in the research. So friends, we have discussed what is bibliography. It is a list of sources that you have used in your article or in your research report or in your thesis. So bibliography, what bibliography is, it is list of sources. If I am reading a report with list of sources, so if I am interested in further research, I can use that bibliographical information for my own interest. So the correct answer will be help those interested in further research. So remember this, the bibliography given in the research helps those interested in further research. Remember the word further research. Now moving on to the next question. Which of the following is plagiarism checking websites? So friends, they have asked websites. I will also tell you that software or the apps are also there. Of the Turnitin is a plagiarism checking website. Grammarly is a grammar check website, but they also do plagiarism check for free. And so these two, and ResearchGate is for researchers profile. You have their ranking and their citations, and journals elsewhere.com, that is third, is a page, sorry, the website of journal, that is elsewhere. So the only 1 and 4, remember Turnitin is a plagiarism checking website, and Grammarly is also plagiarism checking website. So remember this, there may be question, so the correct answer will be 1 and 4. So these are important point, friends. Remember Turnitin and Grammarly for plagiarism checking. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, reference serves the purpose of. So friends, reference in the manuscript or in a report serves a purpose of lending an authenticity to the content. So how it serves this purpose is, like if I am writing something, say any word, that coronavirus is caused by bat, but what is my source? So my reference will be on the top of that statement. There will be a superscript and there will be a number 1, and if you check that number in the last of the report, you will find the reference of a journal or a newspaper article or whatever. So it gives an authenticity. It is not just a statement. It is a statement with proof. So the reference serves as the purpose of lending authenticity to the content. Remember this. Moving on to the next question. The term yellow journalism refers to. So friends, the yellow journalism these days is very commonly used for the sensationalization and exaggeration to attract the readers and viewers. So the correct answer is sensationalization and exaggeration to attract readers and viewers. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, supervisor certification on the thesis. So friends, supervisor's certificate on thesis ensures that the work which is done by the student has actually been done by him and it is true to his knowledge, supervisor's knowledge. So so his certificate serves to ensure the originality of the work, authenticity of the work. So remember this. I hope you got it right. Moving on to the next question. In the classroom, the teacher sends the message either as a word or as an image. The students are really. So what are the students? So friends, when person who generates the message is encoder, and person who receives and draw meanings out of the message is called decoder. So in this case, students are decoder, the teacher is encoder. I hope it, and the channel through which we call it channel. You should know that encoder, message, channel and decoder. So this is the step. So I hope you got it right. Moving on to the next question. Media is also known as. So friends, if you know, the media is known as fourth pillar, that is fourth state of the democracy or any country. I hope you knew this. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, the mode of communication that involves a single source transmitting information to a large number of receivers simultaneously is called. So friends, for this statement, it is valid for TV, radio, or type of communication. So here you have large audience, that is mass audience. So this correct answer is mass communication. Remember, the examples are TV, radio. Moving on to the next question. The greater the handicap of the students coming to the educational institution, the greater is the demand on the. So friends, when there are handicapped student coming, different able student coming with differently able, so here the demand, the greater demand will be on teacher. So he has to put more effort to teach that particular student. Now moving on to the next. The question is, when planning to do a social research, it is better to. Friends, when you are going for a social research, it is better to go with a open mind, because our prejudice may impact or may hurt the outcome of the research. So when planning to do social research, correct answer is one should approach with open mind. First question is, identify the incorrect pair from the following. So the first is, newspaper and its popularity is measured in circulation. So if more is the circulation, newspaper is more popular. As cinema, its popularity is measured in box office terms, like whether it is box office hit or box office flop. And TV, its popularity we know is, it is measured in TRP, but it's not measured in TRP. In popularity rating, is it television viewership in 1000? So this is correct. TV, TVT, television viewership in 1000. And radio popularity is measured in radio audience measurement, not ROD. So the RAM is the correct answer. Radio audience measurement, but here they have given ROD, so this is incorrect. So the incorrect pair of the four is radio ROD, which should have been radio RAM. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, snowball sampling is process of selecting a sample using. So friends, snowball sampling is a process where a network is used. You can see this, where one person select two people and these two people selects further three people. These three people further select more people. So I hope you understood what is snowball sampling is. It is a network of a sample. So the sample you selected selects itself another sampling. So it goes on and you get the large chunk of sample. So the snowball sampling is of network type. So the correct answer will be networks. Remember this. Now moving on to the next question. Research problem is primarily chosen based on. So friends, the main choosing criteria for a research problem is interest of researcher. So it's not about relevance, availability of funds or not availability of funds, availability of literature. It is about what is more interested, what is researcher is interested in. If you are not interested, then there will be no fun doing research. So the correct answer is researcher's interest. Now moving on to the next question. Question is, workshop is meant for. So friends, workshop, a workshop where you go for 2-3 days and do the learn a practical thing, get a practical experience. So the correct answer for this is practical experience. And expert lectures are in seminar, group interaction is different thing, discussion on trading topic is also different thing. In a workshop you get in hand experience. So the correct answer is practical experience. Now moving on to the next question. Sampling method based on the probability. So friends, remember different sampling methods. So there are 5 methods based on the probability. So here the answer is stratified sampling is based on the probability. And what are other methods based on the probability? That is simple random sampling, stratified sampling, cluster sampling, multi-stage sampling and random sampling. Remember these 5 methods, they are based on the probability. So the correct answer here is stratified sampling. I am not telling about the other sampling, I will cover it in the next lecture, but remember for this time you remember the 5 types of sampling, that is simple random sampling, stratified sampling, cluster sampling, multi-stage sampling and random sampling. They comes under the sampling method based on the probability. Now moving on to the next question. So sampling method which is not based on the probability, I hope you just remember what we saw. So the cluster method, stratified sampling and multi-stage sampling, they come under probability sampling. And the one which does not based on the probability is quota sampling. So it is non-probability sampling under stratified sampling. It is non-probability sampling. Remember quota sampling. So the correct answer is here quota samplings. As we discussed, probability samplings are simple random sampling, stratified sampling, cluster sampling, multi-stage sampling and random sampling. These are the sampling based on the probability. So the correct answer for not based on the probability is quota sampling. Now moving on to the next question. In the context of FM radio, FM stands for. So friends, FM radio, FM radio, FM stands for frequency modulation. So this is correct answer. Moving on to the next question. Pick the odd one. So friends, FEG, TSU, NML, RQS. So if you look at it, you can find one common in 1, 2 and 4, that is FEG. If you just write it EFG, STU and 4th QRS. So there is this sequence, but if you write MNL, this won't be correct. LMN will be correct. So the third one is odd here. If you did not find it, you can ask me in the comment section. Moving on to the next. Full form of PDF is. So friends, this is from the ICT. The full form of PDF is portable document format. Now we move to the next. First question is, Larry Tesler, the computer scientist who has recently died, invented. So friends, if you are following the current news, this is very important for the ICT, that is information and communication technology section, where Larry Tesler, who has invented, is known for inventing cut, copy, paste, and in addition to that he has also invented find, replace functions in Microsoft Word, and he has died on this just last Monday. So remember this is current affair thing and which like it has a high probability to be asked in the exam. So the correct answer is Larry Tesler invented cut, copy, paste, and in addition to that find and replace icons. Now moving on to the next question. What is usually used for displaying information at public places? So friends, at monitors is individual, like a computer. Overhead projector is for presentation. Monitors and overhead projector are also for office use, and touch screen kiosks. So this is used for displaying information at public places. Remember this, touch screen kiosks. Moving on to the next question. What does bit mean in computer memory? So friends, they have asked what is the meaning of bit. So friends, 8 bit is 1 byte and its meaning is binary digit. So remember this formula, 1 byte is equal to 8 bit. So our next question is on the same thing. So we'll go to the next question. 1 kilobyte is how much bit in decimal SI unit? So friends, 1 kilobyte is 1000 byte in decimal SI unit. So we have to calculate, if 1 kilobyte is 1000 byte and 1 byte is equal to 8 bit, so we have to multiply 1000 by 8. So the correct answer will be 8000 bits. So 1 kilobyte is 8000 bits. So friends, remember this energy units and their conversion. So they may ask you anyway or in any form, so you have to convert it. If you have any doubt in this question, you can ask me in the comment. So moving on to the next question. A seminar is meant for. So friends, in seminar you go to listen or you give lecture, experts give lecture to the audience. So the correct answer is expert lecture. Seminar is meant for expert lecture. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following is major greenhouse gas? So friends, if you look at the options, A, B, C are greenhouse gases, and D, calcium carbonate, is solid, so it is not a gas. And so of these three, A, B, C, which is major? So the, if you look at the percentage, carbon dioxide is 64% of total major greenhouse gas. So the correct answer is carbon dioxide. I hope you got it right. Moving on to the next question. Question is, audible range of frequency for human ear is. So friends, the audible range means if it is less than this, you will not be able to hear, and if it is more than this, it will be harmful to our ear. So the audible or the optimum range of frequency for human ear is, you have to memorize this, it is 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz, and sound is measured in a unit called decibel. Remember decibel. So the sound is measured in the unit decibel. Now moving on to the next question. Single most significant precursor of acid rain. So friends, we know what acid rain is. Acid rain is rain with sulfuric acid and nitric acid. So this sulfur dioxide is the precursor for the sulfuric acid. So I hope you knew this. The correct answer is sulfur dioxide. Moving on to the next question. Initiative to establish International Solar Alliance was taken by. So friends, its headquarter is in Gurgaon. So obviously India is one of the key initiator of this International Solar Alliance. But who was the next partner or the second partner? So if you know the France, that Emmanuel Macron of Prime Minister of France and Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi, they both started this initiative of International Solar Alliance. So the correct answer is India and France. I hope you got it right. Moving on to the next question. The key element for effective communication is. So they have asked, what is the key element of effective communication? Passivity. So this itself is not passivity means not motivated or no interest. So this won't be helpful for effective communication. Negativity also will not help. Deflection is a diversion from the topic, also will not help for the communication. Advocacy, that is supporting other individual while talking or in communication, is the key for the effective communication. Remember this, advocacy is the key for the effective communication. Now we have the question which you have to answer. I will not answer it. And the dance of honeybees conveying the location of nectar to the other honeybees. So this dance is also called waggle dance, is an example of which type of communication? So friends, if you look at the honeybees, they are a team, they are a group. So communication between the group or between the team is called group communication, and mass communication is not, this cannot be called mass communication, because mass communication you get very big audience, because like TV, newspaper or radio are example of mass communication. And interpersonal communication means you communicate with yourself, person's own communication. And the intrapersonal communication is communication within himself, and interpersonal means between two persons. So this also won't apply. So as I said that honeybees are a team, so this is a group communication. So the correct answer will be group communication. Moving on to the next question. The question is CHEER, that is cheer stands for. So friends, this is very important, as this was asked in the previous exams many times. So the CHEER, cheer stands for children enrichment education through radio. This is about the radio education of the children. So the cheer stands for children enrichment education through radio. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is the most important aspects of communication, that is listening, can be improved by. So the options are A, by making attention fully paid, the fully paid attention. So yes, with fully paid attention listening can be improved. Making the communicated material interesting and need based. Yeah, this is also, if material is interested and it is need based, then the listener will be more attentive, and it will improve the listening. Now making voice effective and impressive. Yeah, this is also correct. So the options, correct option will be D, all of the above. Now moving on to the next question. Educational TV was first introduced in India in the year. So they have asked the year when educational TV was introduced. So friends, the educational TV was first introduced in India in 1959, and it was broadcasted from Bombay, nowadays Mumbai. So the correct answer is 1959. Remember this. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following cannot be good way of communication in promoting literacy among villagers? So friends, if you look at the demography of literacy, the village or rural India is comparatively less literate than the urban area. So there the option which should not be implemented is reading and writing, because most of the people, at least some part of the people, will not be able to read and write. So this should not be implemented. Demonstration, providing material on TV and film projector, and large group discussion can be implemented, but reading and writing won't be a good idea, because large chunk of the villagers will not be able to read and write. So this is correct. Moving on to the next question. The process of communication enhances through. So friends, process of communication enhances through belongingness, security and freedom to make choices. Yeah, this is also correct. Informality of meeting and avoidance of pressure. Yeah, this also correct. So all of the above. Moving on to the next question. Next is a series where they have given 1, 2, 3, 1, 4, 9 and 1, 27. So friends, if you give a closure or look at this problem. So here you see 1, 2, 3, and then next, if you square of 1 is 1, then square of 2 will be 4 and square of 3 will be 9. Now in next, cube of 3 will be 27 and cube of 2 will be 8. So the correct answer is 8. This is very simple. I hope you got it. If there is any problem, you can ask me in the comment section. Now the next question is, it is little bit difficult, you may find it difficult, but once you read it and try to solve, it will be easier. 6, 5, 24, 25, 144, because you don't see any relation here, but if you carefully look at it, the first term is, the third term is 4 times of first term. 6 into 4, it will be 24, third term. And if you look at the fourth term, it is 5 times of second term, and if you look at 6th term, it is 6 times of third term, that is 144. Now the next term should be how much? 7 times of 25, so it will be 175. I hope you got it. The explanation is here, you can read it, what I have said. Now moving on to the next question. all are the components of listening except, so they have given the component of listening, but there is one which is not the component of listening. So what is that component? First is hearing. Yes, this is also component of listening. Attending and being attentive. Yes, this is also component of listening. D, understanding and remembering. Yes, this is also component of listening. But answering is not a component of listening. So the correct answer is answering. Now moving on to the last question. Dash dash is approximately equals to trillion byte. So friends, I have explained it earlier. Gigabyte stands for billion byte. Megabyte stands for million byte. Kilobyte stands for thousand byte. And terabyte stands for trillion byte. So the correct answer is terabyte. I hope you gave it right. Moving on to the next question. Dash dash allows transfer of voice over internet. So friends, how the voice over internet is transferred? So the technology, they asked which technology used. So if you know that Jio, which was launched in 2016, they use voice over internet protocol. That is also called internet telephony. So remember these two words, voice over internet protocol is used to transfer the voice over the internet. So it is called voice over internet protocol is also called internet telephony. So the correct answer is internet telephony. I hope you knew this. Moving on to the next question. Control, shift and alter are called which type of keys? So they are modifier. Remember this, control, shift and alter keys are modifier keys. Moving on to the next question. Educational TV was first introduced in India in the year 1959 from. So they have asked the broadcasting station in which city it was broadcasted from. So friends, in 1959 educational TV was broadcasted from then Bombay and now Mumbai. So I hope you knew this. Moving on to the next question. Computer uses dash dash number system to store the data and perform the calculation. So friends, the computer uses binary number system to store the data and perform the calculations faster. So the correct answer is binary. Moving on to the next question. An error in a computer is called. So friends, error in a computer software is what is it called? It is called a bug. Error in a computer software is called bug. Moving on to the next question. What should be a strong password, or what should a strong password should contain? So friends, this is we come often across this problem where we are being asked to either have a capital letter, one capital letter, one lowercase letter and number, any possible a symbol. So the of these four options, the correct answer will be capital letters, lowercase letter and numbers. Moving on to the next question. NEFT in an Indian banking system stands for. So friends, you may be knowing the banking protocol. So our next three questions will be about these banking transfer protocols. So NEFT is a national electronic fund transfer, and here the fund will not be transferred instantly. So if you process it now, it will by the end of day it will be transferred, or by the end of working hour, or after 1 hour it will be transferred. So it is not instant transfer. It is national electronic fund transfer. Remember, NEFT is national electronic fund transfer, and here fund is transferred in batches and not instantly. So this is one difference. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is RTGS in an Indian banking system stands for. So friends, RTGS is used by a firm or by banks among to transfer a big amount, a more amount. Remember this, and it is real time gross settlement. So it is transferred instantly. So this is for instant transfer. I hope you knew this. The answer is real time gross settlement. Now moving on to the next and the question is, set of moral principles a researcher should follow while conducting a research. So friends, a set of moral principles which every researcher should follow while conducting research is called research ethics. So remember this, research ethics is a set of moral principles which researcher should follow while conducting a research. Now moving on to the next question. The act of publishing the same data and result in more than one journal or a publication, refers to. So friends, here a situation is given when I have one particular result. I published it in one journal, and then I also published same result, same data in other journal. So I get two publication, but this is not ethical and it is called duplicate publication. Remember friends, this is very important. Duplicate publication is called duplicate publication when you publish one result in two journals or in two publications. So moving on to the next question. The next question is, which term refers to publishing several articles from data collected in one large study? So friends, here a researcher has collected a lot of data in one go, and now he is publishing one part of data in one journal, then he is publishing one part of that data in other journal. So it is called partial publication and it is not duplicate publication, as we seen in the earlier, where duplicate publication is you publish the same result in two publications. But here he is studying one big large data, and that he is dividing into 1, 2, 3, that type of thing. Then this is called partial publication. This is not unethical. Remember, duplicate publication is unethical. Partial publication is not unethical. This is ethical. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following is necessary in obtaining the informed consent? So friends, when you are carrying out sampling, and you know the type of research you are conducting, so for your sample or your audience, you should take an informed consent by describing them all the things, including the purpose of the research. So the correct answer is, when you are taking an informed consent, it should be with the description of the purpose of the research. Now moving on to the next question. Which of the following need to be obtained when doing a research with children? So friends, when your sample or your sample is children, so then you should have a consent from parent, that is must, and then assent, approval from the child if she or he is capable, if she understand what type of research is going on or what will be done with her study. So her approval also should be taken. So the correct answer will be both A and B, and not the informed consent of the child. So here you should, it is mandatory that you have informed consent from the parent or a guardian, from the guardian of the children. Now moving on to the next question. Research participant must give what before they can participate in the study? So friends, whenever you are starting a research or any study, there should be a guidelines laid before you start it. So the correct answer is, when you start a research, before that you should set a guidelines. So the correct answer is guideline. Moving on to the next question. The question is, which of following is not true? So they have given four statements. Of these, one is false. So we'll read one by one. Misrepresenting and creating a fraud data is dishonesty. So friends, where there is fraud, it is dishonesty. So this is correct statement. Statement C is, misrepresenting data can be difficult to detect. So friends, this is also correct. When some researcher or a student misrepresented data and produce it, so it is very difficult to detect, because it is very big database, any journal or any publication house, it is difficult for them to identify the misrepresentation. So the correct answer will be, misrepresenting data is very easy to detect. It is not that easy. If I am quoting something, so for proving me wrong, he has to prove the correct result. So it is not that easy. It is a tedious process. So the correct answer is, misrepresenting data is very easy to detect. Remember, it is not easy to detect. Moving on to the next question. Ideally, the research participant's identity is not known to the researcher. So friends, here your sample identity is not known to you. When you are giving some poll on Google spreadsheet or say Google poll, there your identity is hidden. So in this case, it is called anonymous. Remember this, when researcher himself don't know participant's identity, it is called anonymity. Remember this. Now moving on to the next question. What is called when participants are not revealed to the anyone but researcher and staff? So in the here they have said that sample's identity is known to the researcher and staff, but the final user or the report, their identity is not disclosed. So here this is called confidentiality. friends. So this is confidential, we say. So the correct answer is here, researcher knows, but no researcher and staff knows, but other people don't know. So this is called confidentiality. Remember this term. Now moving on to the next question.
The question is, government agency responsible for collection of various types of data in India is CSO. So friends, CSO stands for, the options are A, Central Statistical Organization, B, Central Statistics Office, and Central Staff Organization, D, Central Staff Office. So friends, CSO, as you know, that many data they release, like the very recently released employment data, the full form of the CSO is B, Central Statistics Office. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Moving on to the next question. The question is, NPTEL project funded by MHRD stands for. So friends, the NPTEL is a joint initiative between MHRD and IITs, where you will have the online lecture by IIT faculties available on the online platform, and everybody in India can watch them. So the full form for NPTEL is, the correct answer is National Program on Technology Enhanced Learning. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. The question is, find out the next term in the following series. So friends, I have also included the mathematical reasoning questions in this mock test. So you will have more such questions. Now coming to this question, where the number series is 0, 3, 8, 15, 24. So this is a simple question to begin with. If you just take out the differences between the adjacent number, so it is in the 0 and 3 it is 3, and from 3 to 8 it is 5, and from 8 to 15 it is 7, and from 15 to 24 it is 9. Now the next number difference should be 11, so if you add 11 to 24 it will be a 35. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is from the environmental section. Which plant is used in biodiesel? So friends, if you have studied or if you know, then only you will be able to answer this question. And the correct answer for this question is jatropha. So jatropha is used for the biodiesel making. Now moving on to the next question. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Next question is, which of the following will not come under natural hazard? So friends, this is a simple question. If you are able to answer, if you read the question carefully, which of the following does not come under the natural hazard? So if you see, flood is a natural hazard, volcanic eruption is a natural hazard, earthquake is natural hazard, and as you know, the plane crash, it can be a technical or it can be a human error or it can be anything, but it won't come under the natural hazard. So the correct answer here is plane crash. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, what is the full form of NEET, an examination for admission into medical courses in India? So friends, generally like this is very common term, but many of us don't know the exact full form of the NEET. Now the options are National Employment Cum Entrance Test, the National Eligibility and Exam Test, the National Entrance and Eligibility Test. Option D is the National Eligibility Cum Entrance Test. So friends, the correct answer for the long form of the NEET is National Eligibility Cum Entrance Test. So remember this, though this is very common, but generally we are not aware of it. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, lead tetraethyl is added to gasoline to make. So friends, this is also from the environmental section, and options are to make gasoline thin, to increase its speed, to decrease the fumes. So friends, the correct answer is it is added to gasoline because of its anti-knock property. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, Ray Tomlinson introduced this symbol. So friends, this is important a personality in the field of information and communication technology, where he has introduced the symbol at the rate. He is a computer programmer, died recently in 2016, and he introduced this symbol at the rate. Generally we use it for email and giving the various type of addresses. So I hope you have answered this correctly. So @symbol was introduced by Ray Tomlinson. So you may be asked who introduced this symbol other way, like they may also ask you the name of the programmer. So remember this name and the symbol. Ray Tomlinson has introduced the @symbol. Now moving on to the next question. Which of the following is unique numeric identifier used to specify particular host computer? Now friends, they have asked you the numeric identifier. So friends, as you know, any particular on the host on network can be identified with IP address. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Moving on to the next question.
Which of the following is the first step in starting the research process? So friends, they have asked, what is the first step of starting the research process? So friends, it is similar like you go to the doctor and he diagnoses what is the problem. So the identification of the problem is the first step in the research. So remember, this identification of the problem is the first step in the research. Now moving on to the next question. Action research means. So friends, action research is a research carried out to solve a immediate problem. So here the solution here demand to have a solution is quick, and you need a rapid action, rapid solution. So this is called rapid research, when it is a research initiated to solve a immediate problem. Remember this. Moving on to the next question. The question is, a common test in research demands much priority on. So they have asked, what a test carried out in research should have the qualities or the priorities. So first is, it should be reliable. This is correct. It should be usable to others who wish to continue your research or want to use your common test. So it should be usable, and it should be objectivity. So it should be it should have some purpose. So all of this is the correct action. Any common test in research should have reliability, usability and objectivity. So the correct answer will be all of the above. Moving on to the next question. The essential qualities of a researchers are. So option A is, if spirit of free inquiry, yes, he should have spirit of free inquiry, he should not be biased. Reliance on observation and evidence, yeah, he should rely on the observation and evidence and not be prejudice. Systemization and theorizing of knowledge, yeah, this is also correct. So the correct answer is all of the above. Moving on to the next question. What is bibliometry? So friends, we have seen the bibliography, which is a list of all the information or the sources used in the article. But bibliometry is a information management tool used for analysis of a journal or for book or for article. So remember this. This is new term, bibliometry. It is an information management tool used in the library science for analyzing books, article and journal. So moving on to the next question. Which of the following is the correct chronology of the internet facilities? So friends, they have given us four giants in the internet world, and they have asked us their chronology. So here they have asked which was founded first and which was founded the recent one. So friends, if you know that Amazon was founded on 1994 by Jeff Bezos, and Google was founded in 1998 by Sergey Brin and Larry Page, and Facebook we all use is founded in 2004 by Mark Zuckerberg, and then Snapchat is the recent addition, which is founded in 2011. So the correct answer will be D11. So friends, for communication, electronic communication, remember these things. The correct answer will be D, Amazon 1994, Google 1998, Facebook 2004 and Snapchat 2011. I hope you got your answer right. Moving on to the next question. The next question is, identify the correct pair from the following. First is Amazon Sabir Bhatia. This is incorrect, because Amazon was founded by Jeff Bezos and Sabir Bhatia is known for Hotmail. And the Twitter was founded by Jack Dorsey, who is also it's a CEO. And Julian Assange is known for WikiLeaks. And YouTube was founded by Javed Karim and co-founder. And Jimmy Wales is known for the free website, that is Wikipedia. We all know that. And Julian Assange is known for WikiLeaks. Remember these the top internet giants and who is their founder. So the correct answer is Google, which was founded by Sergey Brin and Larry Page. So the correct answer is B, Sergey Brin, Google. Moving on to the next question. Next question is educationalist and their special educational contribution. So choose the correct pair from the following. So friends, here they have asked Louis Braille. So if you know the Braille language is for the blind learners. Remember, this Braille language is for blind learners, and Louis Braille was French educationalist. Now second, Helen Keller. She was the first deaf and blind graduate in 1900. So she is known for dumb and deaf learner. And Thomas Edison is a famous scientist who invented the electric bulb, who is known for inventing electric bulb. He also is has a great contribution for deaf learners, as he has invented the phonogram. Yeah, you remember, he has invented the phonogram for the deaf learner. And Thomas Edison, he himself was a deaf by 1 year, and his other ear had a deficiency of 80%. So you can imagine his all the contribution. And he has also developed the phonogram. And Lal Advani, not to confused with Lal Krishna Advani, he is a founder of Indian Institute of Handicap in Dehradun. So these are the correct answer will be what? 3C, that is Braille for blind learners, Helen Keller for dumb and deaf learners, Thomas Edison for deaf learners, and Lal Advani for handicapped learners. So this was a bit difficult, but it was very informative for the education, from the education point of view. Now moving on to the next question. Abhijit goes to singing class. Which type of education is this? So friends, singing requires a master or expert. So a learning under expert is formal education. So the correct answer is formal education. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following resource is renewable? So coal is non-renewable, petroleum is non-renewable, natural gas is non-renewable, forest is renewable. So that's why you call afforestation when we plant forest. So the correct answer will be forest. Moving on to the sixth question. Dash dash is mainly responsible for depletion of ozone in the stratosphere. So friends, as we know, chlorofluorocarbon is mainly responsible for depletion of ozone in the stratosphere. And to ban or to minimize the use of chlorofluorocarbon, the Montreal Protocol was adopted in 1987. So the correct answer is chlorofluorocarbon. Now moving on to the next question. Which type of waste is classified as hazardous? So if you look at household, commercial and agricultural, so they are not classified as hazardous. The chemical waste is classified as hazardous waste. I hope you got it right. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, what is the full form of ICSSR? So friend, ICSSR is Indian Council of Social Science Research. Like we have CSIR for Council for Scientific and Industrial Research. For the social sciences, the main body which looks after the research activity is Indian Council of Social Science Research, and its headquarters is in Delhi. So remember this, the mark is D, but the correct answer here is A, Indian Council of Social Science Research. Moving on to the next question. Technical and scientific education was given in. So friends, these are the earlier or medieval or pre-medieval educational system. So technical and scientific education was given in the Buddhist system of education. I hope you got it correct. Next question is, identify the incorrect pair from the following. So friends, TTF is for font file, this is correct. .wav is for audio file extension. They have given the file and the extension. So JPG is for graphic image file, this is also correct. So the only .exe is for executable file and not for exclusive data file. So the incorrect pair is .exe, so that is D. I hope you got it right. Moving on to the next question. The question is, study of body language is called. So friends, there are five types of non-verbal communication, and the study of body language in non-verbal communication is called kinesics, and study of space in communication or space or distance is called proxemics. Study of sign language is called semiotics. Study of body language, as we discussed, is kinesics, and study of touch, communication via touch, is haptics, and study of time, communication time, is pronemics. So remember these five theories and what are they called and on what basis they are called. So you remember this, there may be one question based on this. So for our question, study of body language is called kinesics. Moving on to the next question. Now they have asked us to find out the missing number. So here, if you look at first two diagrams, 5, 3 and then 6, 8. So if you multiply 5 by 3, it will be 15, and 6 into 8, it will be 48. And if you add 15 plus 48, it will be 63. So this is the relation. You have to multiply top two numbers and bottom two numbers and then add them. Now similarly, in second case, 2 into 7 will be 14, and 3 into 9 will be 27. So if you add 14 plus 27, it will be 41. Now for our what they have asked is, what will be the missing number in third case. So third case, you can simply do it. 6 into 7 will be 42, and then bottom will be 8 into 5 will be 40. So total will be 40 plus 42 will be 82. So the correct answer will be 82. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, young is related to old in the same way. Wide will be related to. So friends, they have young is related to old. So this is young, and like they have, this is opposite of, they have asked the opposite word of wide. So wide is wider, then you call narrower, or the narrow is short or short path. So long, I can tell you the long opposite word for long will be short. For for big, opposite word will be small. For for C, short, it will be long, and for narrow it is wide. So the correct answer will be narrow. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, summer is coded as runner, so winter will be coded as. So friends, if you look at the reasoning, or say the relationship in summer to runner, is here, if I have written here, they have first letter, it is minus 1, that is R. Yes, they have written R, and second letter is same, so I have written 0. And for M, they have added one more, so in place of M they have used N, and for next M also they have used N, so 1, and then last two letters are similar. So the second, fifth and sixth letter is same, so you don't have to change it, and just have to check it in the options. So if you look at the options, it is not changed in the B, where wire, that is option B. So if you write, it will be the correct answer. If anyone has any doubt, they can ask. The correct answer is wire, that is option B. Winter will be coded as fire. Here just six letters, only three have changed, and first is they have minus 1, and third and fourth are plus 1 plus 1. So this is the correct answer, wire. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, what is the full form of NIRF? So the national, so friends, it is the national ranking framework where they rank our technical institute, that is engineering institute, colleges, universities. So there are management, pharmaceutical, different rankings for different branches. So the long form for NIRF is National Institutional Ranking Framework. The correct answer is B. I hope you got it right. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, in which state of in which state the first children's university was established in India? So friends, in Gujarat's Gandhinagar in 2009, the first children's university was established. Next question is, modern teaching system support system includes. So friends, green board, charts, maps, they are not modern, they are being used for long time nowadays, or the tech in this technological world, smart boards are used. So friends, the correct answer is smart board and not green board here. The modern teaching support system includes the smart boards. The correct answer is A, smart board. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, the world's first computer, ENIAC, was developed in the year. So friends, the ENIAC was the first digital computer which was used without any mechanical instrument. So it was developed in the year 1945. Remember this. Moving on to the next question. Most of the state universities are dash dash in nature. So friends, if you have studied from the universities, or very few universities are autonomous. All the universities, almost all the state universities are affiliated. Remember this, all the state university are affiliating universities. So option A is correct. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, in context of internet, what is the full form of FTP? So friends, full form of FTP is file transfer protocol. So the correct answer is D, file transfer protocol. Moving on to the next question. The question is, which of the following represents smallest addressable unit of memory? So friends, options are terabyte, kilobyte, byte, gigabyte. So the smallest addressable unit of memory is byte and not bit. Remember this, the correct answer is byte. Moving on to the next question. The question is, R is daughter of Q, M is sister of B, who is son of Q? How M and R are related? So friends, we'll see each statement. First statement is, R is daughter of Q. So this is clear, and it says that M is sister of B. Okay, and it again says that B is son of Q. So now it is very clear that Q has a son B and daughter M, and again daughter R. So there are two daughters. Q has two daughters, R and M, and son B. So here M and R are sisters. I hope you got this clear, because in this blood relation you have to read it carefully and just draw these diagrams and you will get the answer. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, half byte is known as. So friends, half byte is known as nibble. I hope you knew this. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following represents 1 million character? So friends, I already told you that kilobyte represents the 1000 byte, megabyte represents the million byte, gigabyte represents the billion byte, and terabyte represents the trillion byte. So megabyte represents the million characters. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, with SCD you can. So friend, CD is only readable device, so you can only read with CD. I hope you got your answer right. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, when we work on any documents on PC, it is stored temporarily on. So friends, when we work on any document, it is temporarily stored on RAM, that is random access memory. I hope you got it correct. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, breaking a logical memory into blocks of same size. Remember this, breaking a logical memory into blocks of same size is called pages. This is factual questions. Remember this. Moving on to the next question. The question is, this is also a blood relation problem. Pointing to a photograph of a boy, Mr. Ram said, he is the son of, only son of my mother. So here, how Mr. Ram is related to that boy? So friends, what he has said, that we should see the statement, read clearly, he is the son of, only son of my mother. So here Ram is referring his mother. So his mother, okay, so and to the boy, his second generation. So the boy is, or he is the son of Ram. Remember this. So the Ram is related to boys. So here Ram is father of a boy. I hope you got it. This is not very difficult. If you just read question carefully, you will be able to answer this. Moving on to the next question. Question is, pointing to a woman, Abhijit said, her granddaughter is the only daughter of my brother. How is the woman related to Abhijit? So friends, the woman in question has a granddaughter. So this is two generation problem, and when she has a granddaughter, she also has a father who is the brother of Abhijit. So here the woman in question is related with Abhijit. Here she is a mother of Abhijit. Remember, I hope you got this problem. The trick in this problem is you just have to read the statement carefully and draw this diagram accordingly. So the answer is mother. So friend, this was it for today. If you have liked it, please subscribe to Global Online University. Thank you for watching. Question is, look at the series and find the next number. So friend, the series is like 7 10 8 11 9 12. So and they have asked us next number. If you take out the difference between the first and second number, it is 3. From second to third number, it is 2. So it is going down by 2. And again from third to fourth number, it is going up by 3. From fourth to fifth number, it is going down by 2. Then again fifth to sixth number, it is going up by 3. Now it should come down again. After 12, it should come down by 2. So the next number will be 10. I hope you got your answer right. If you have any doubt, you can comment. Moving on to the next question. The question is, find the odd pair from the following So the question, the pairs are, mason builds a wall, cobbler stitches shoe, and farmer grows crop, and chef cook. So here this is odd because chef cooks food. So chef and the pair should have been chef and food and not chef and cook. So the correct answer is chef and cook is the odd word. I hope you got it correct. Moving on to the next question. The question is, which among the following states has the highest number of seats in the Lok Sabha? So friends, I don't know which state you belong to, but I come from Maharashtra, which has 48 seats, Rajasthan, which has 25 seats, Tamil Nadu has 39 seats, and West Bengal has 42 seats. So among the options, the Maharashtra has maximum seats, that is 48. And the highest number of MP seats in India, if you know, it is Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh has 80 plus seat. I don't remember the exact number. So the correct answer is Maharashtra, which has 48 seat. The question is, India has the largest higher education system in the world after. So they have asked the rank of India. So friends, we are third ranked in terms of higher education system, and we are behind United States and China. Remember this. So India's education system is third, behind United States and China. So the correct answer is 4A and C only. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following are the goals of higher education in India? So first, access. Yes, the access is access to everyone is the goal. B, equity. Everyone should be involved. So yes, this is the goal. Then quality and excellence. Yes, this is also a goal. Relevance. It should be relevant to the modern times. Yes, it is also a goal. E, value-based education. Yes, this is also a goal. And F, compulsory and free education. Friends, for higher education, this is not the goal. We only provide, Indian government only. Now, that was not there initially, but just they have incorporated only primary education as compulsory and free education. We, Indian government, don't provide. They don't have goal of compulsory and free higher education. So this is not the goal. So remaining all are the goals. So A, B, C, D, E. So correct option is 3. Now moving on to the next question. The next question is, purpose of value education is best served by focusing on. So options are, cultural practices prevailing in the society, norms of conduct laid down by social group, concern for human values, and religious and moral practice and instruction. So friends, purpose of value education is best served if it is focused on human values. Remember this, if it is focused on concern for human values. Moving on to the next question. The first question is, according to UGC, which state has most number of universities? So this is interesting questions, question friends. So I will tell you, most number of universities are in Rajasthan. The number is 76. And second thing is, they have also the most number of private university, that is 46, that is also in Rajasthan. And most number of deemed university, that is 28, are in Tamil Nadu. And most number of state universities are in Uttar Pradesh, that is 29. So remember this four thing. So the correct answer for this question is, most number of universities are in Rajasthan and number is 76. I hope you knew this. First question is, unit used to measure noise level is. So friends, here they have asked, what is the unit used to measure noise level, that is sound or the our voice. How big is our voice? It is measured in one particular unit. If you remember it, I will read all options and I'll tell you what they are used for. First, joule is used for energy. PPM is for concentration. Bit is for memory. And dB, that is decibel, is for noise level. So remember this, decibel is for noise level. PPM is part per million, is for concentration. And bit for memory. And joule for energy. So remember, so you can answer any question related to other units too. Moving on to the next question. Using someone else's research without due acknowledgement is called. So friends, using someone else's research without a due acknowledgement is called. So friends, this is theft. In a common or layman's word, it will be called theft. But in scientific or research field, it is called plagiarism. Remember this, if you are taking someone else's work and you are using someone else's work and not giving due credit to the person, then it is called plagiarism. So, and when you give someone a credit, you give it in the form of reference, that is bibliograph. Okay, now moving on to the next question. I hope you got this correct. Convention on ozone depleting substances is known as. So friends, it is in 1987 Montreal Protocol was formed for ozone depleting substances, that is ODS. Remember ODS, and then what should come in your mind is Montreal Protocol, ozone depleting substances, ODS, then it's Montreal Protocol. It was finalized in 1987. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, Green India Mission was part of. So friends, Green India Mission of India is part of National Action Plan for Climate Change. I hope you knew this. The correct answer is National Action Plan for Climate Change. Green India Mission is National Action Plan for Climate Change. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, International Solar Alliance was established to cooperation in developing solar energy was proposed by. So friends, it is a proud thing for India that International Solar Alliance was first proposed by Indian Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi after coming to the power in 2015. So remember this, Narendra Modi has proposed this. He is the Indian Prime Minister, so he has proposed this for the first time. So International Solar Alliance, when it comes, you should remember that it was proposed by Prime Minister, Indian Prime Minister. Going on to the next question. Next question is, concentration of toxic chemicals through food chain results into. So friends, concentration of food toxic chemicals through food chain results into biomagnification. So remember this, biomagnification is, see, the toxic food chains going from the lower level primary to the highest level, it the concentration of the toxic material increases. So this is called biomagnification. And I hope you got your answer correct. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which communication service has been recently closed in India? So friends, if you remember, you can still send a post, so postal service is not closed. Landline, you can still make a landline call, though not many people have it in home, but it is still there in government offices and still there in some houses too. And fax, you still have fax, but Telegram is closed, not the Telegram app, the Telegram service is closed of government. And remember this, that last telegram was sent to Rahul Gandhi. So the recent service which is closed is Telegram. I hope you got it right. Move on to the next question. Which of the following is not characteristic of good hypothesis? So friend, any hypothesis, when you or anyone proposes, it should have testability, it should be testable, and it should have objective, and it should also have conceptual clarity. So these things are important, but it should not be complex. Then when it is complex, you cannot test it. So the correct answer is, it should not not a good characteristic of a hypothesis is complexity. So I hope you got it right. Move on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following is the lowest level of cognitive ability? So friends, remember this, we also have discussed the highest level of cognitive ability, that was evolution. If you remember Bloom's taxonomy chart, I will so you can see here, this is Bloom's taxonomy chart. Remember, and read it again, the top, the highest level of cognitive ability is evolution, and the lowest level of cognitive ability is knowledge, that is knowing the things. So the correct answer is knowing the thing. I hope you got it right. Now moving on to the next question. The question is, identify the correct pair from the following. So friends, 1 kilobyte, this is memory unit we see, and 1 kilobyte is 1000. So here it is not 1000, it is 10,000, so it is incorrect. And C option, 1 gigabyte, 1 billion. In 1 billion, you will have 9 zeros. Remember this, and in 1 trillion, you will have 12 zeros. So 1 gigabyte is also wrong, because it should be 10 raised to 9. Option C is wrong. And option D, that is terabyte, means trillion characters. So here there should be 10 raised to 12. So this is also wrong. But megabyte, 10 raised to 6, 10 zero, 6 zeros on 1. So this is 1 megabyte is 1 million. So this is correct. I hope you remember this, or if you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. So the correct pair is 1 megabyte is 1 million character. So the 10 raised to power 6 is correct. For gigabyte, 10 raised to power 9. And for terabyte, 10 raised to power 12. And for kilobyte, 10 raised to power 3 is correct. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following is the correct full form of CBFC in the context of Indian films? So friends, CBFC is an organization which gives the certificate based on the content to the films, like A, B or C grade, we say that. So it is Central Board of Film Certification. So I hope you got this correct. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, in the context of journalism, what is mean by page 3 news? So friends, if you follow page 3, you will be knowing this. It is about the entertainment industry, it is about celebrities, it is about social lives of stars and celebrities. So the correct answer is soft stories on social and personal lives of celebrity and stars. So remember this. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, a dash dash is used to show the exact value. So friends, read question carefully. A dash dash is used to show the exact value. If you see option A, pie chart, so it is a chart. Here you get the idea, but not the exact value. In bar diagram or dot plot, all those things show you the relativity, but the table where you get the exact value. In table, you don't get the approximate value, you get what is the exact value. So the correct answer is table. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, in the context of computer generated type text, identify the odd non-verbal clue from the following. So friend, if you read the options, bold, italic, underline, and emoji, emoticon. So emoticon is the odd member in this series, so you can say the emoticon is the odd member. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, At present, a person is 4 times older than his son and is 3 years older than his wife. After 3 years, the age of the son will be 15 years. And the age of the person's wife after 5 years will be. So they have asked us the age of person's wife. So at present, the person's age is 4 times that of his son. And after 3 years, his son's age will be 15 years. So at this stage, the son's age is 12 years. So you multiply it by 4. So it will be like 48. Now today, the person's age is 48. And after 5 years, it will be 53. And wife is 3 years younger to the husband or the person. So you can deduce the age, it is 50. So I have just said it, you can also do mathematically, but once reading question 2-3 times also you can answer this question. The correct answer is 50. If there is any problem, you can mention it in comment section. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, a good teacher is one who. So friends, it is said that a teacher is also a leader. So when a teacher who inspires students to learn is a good teacher. Remember this, a teacher who inspires students to learn is a good teacher. Moving on to the next question. The question is, which of the following represents 1 billion characters? So friends, 1 kilobyte represents 1000 bytes, 1 megabyte represents million bytes, and gigabyte represents billion characters and billion bytes, and terabyte represents trillion. So remember this. So the correct answer, the billion here, billion characters will be represented by gigabyte, and trillion by terabyte, and 1000 by kilobyte, and million by megabyte. Remember this. Moving on to the next question. The question is, which of the following combinations represents renewable natural resources? So option A is oil, forest and tide. This is ruled out because oil is not renewable natural resource. B is fertile soil, fresh water, natural gas. This also is ruled out because natural gas is not renewable natural source. And C, clean air, phosphates and biological diversity. So phosphates are not renewable natural resources. So this is ruled out. And then D, fishes, fertile soil and fresh water. So this is renewable natural resources. So the correct answer is D, fishes, fertile soil and fresh water. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following steps are required to design a questionnaire? So friends, I will read it. A, writing a primary and secondary aims of study. This is required. B, review of the current literature. This is also required. C, prepare a draft of questionnaire. This is also required. And D, revision of a draft. So this is also required. So all A, B, C, D are required. Correct answer is A, all of the above. Now moving on to the next question. The question is, male and female students perform equally well in a numerical aptitude test. So they have asked which this statement is which hypothesis. So friends, here male and female students have performed equally well. There is no considerable difference in their performance. So this is null hypothesis. Remember this, when there is no considerable difference, it is null hypothesis. Moving on to the next question. The question is, which of the following statements about teaching aids are correct? We'll read the statements. So first is, they are helpful in retaining the concept for longer duration. So friends, it is a well-known fact that if you understand the concept clearly, you can retain that concept for longer time. So yes, teaching aids help you understand concept clearly, so that way you can retain the concept for longer duration. This is correct. They help students learn better. This is also right. They ease learning. And see, they make teaching learning process interesting. This is also correct. And they enhance rote learning. So this is not correct. Only A, B, C are correct. So I hope you got it correct, the answer. Moving on to the next question. Question is, achievement tests are commonly used for the purpose of. So friends, they have asked the achievement test, what is the purpose of taking the achievement test? So friends, achievement test is used for assessing the amount of learning after the teaching. I hope you knew this. moving on to the next question. Next question is teaching used by a teacher to teach. Sorry. Techniques used by teacher to teach includes. So they are one, lecture. Yes, this is the technique. B, interactive lecture. Yes, this also a technique. And group work is also a technique. But see, self-study is not a technique used by teacher. So self-study is it has to be done by the student, right? So the correct answer will be the A, B, C. So here in case of B, we have this. So the correct answer is B. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is the conclusion or the findings of which type of research cannot be generalized to other situations. So friends, see, casual or comparative research, okay, you can generalize or you can compare. And descriptive research also you can help to find, you can use this situation for other. And experimental research, okay, you have database and you can compare your results. But in historical research, you cannot do this. It cannot be generalized for the other situation because it has already happened and you cannot generalize it. Okay, so the correct answer is historical research. The findings of historical research cannot be generalized to other situation. Remember this. Moving on to the next question. The question is, which of the following is highest level of cognitive abilities? So friends, cognitive ability is the brain related skills to perform any task. Be it simple to any complex task. So this brain related cognitive ability is divided into six parts by Bloom. So this is called Bloom's taxonomy, where he has put knowledge, that is knowing the things, at the first thing, then understanding, that is comprehension, second, then application, so applying is third, then analysis, that is fourth, and then synthesis, and the sixth one is evaluation. So remember this. The highest level of cognitive ability is evaluation, that is evaluating. I hope you got your answer right. Moving on to the next question. The question is, a good thesis writing should involve. So they have asked us what are the good thesis writing practices. So the first thing is a reduction of punctuation and grammatical errors to a minimum. So this is correct because you should not have you should reduce the grammatical and punctuational errors to the minimum, as minimum as it can be. And B, careful checking of references. Yes, this also should be done because you have to have proper references and it should not be a mismatch. Like for say, you cannot have a reference one and then you have at one you have some different references. So this bibliography, so this careful checking of references, so it should be properly bibliographed. And C, consistency in the way thesis is written. Yes, it should have some consistency related to your work. It should not be random, like there should be some consistency. Yes, this is also there. And D, a clear and well written abstract. Yes, it is very important to have clear and well written abstract. So I think this all four points are needed for good written thesis. So the correct answer will be A, B, C, D. Moving on to the next question. The question is, Jim Piaget gave a theory of cognitive development of humans on the basis of his. So friends, Jim Piaget is a Swiss psychologist who gave his theory of cognitive development based on his fundamental research. Remember this. Moving on to the next question. The question is, among the following statements, two are contradictory to each other. Select the correct code that represent them. So they have asked us to select the two contradictory statements to each other. So first statement is, all poets are philosophers. Okay, and B, some poets are philosophers. These are not contradictory. Some poets are not philosophers. So here this is contradictory because in first statement they have said that all poets are philosophers. So some poets are not philosophers. So this is contradictory. So the correct answer will be D, A, and C. Now moving on to the next question. The question is, which of the following is not a principle of effective communication? So friend, one-way transfer of information, that is monologue, is not a principle of effective communication. Remember this, one-way communication is not an effective communication. The question is, In communication, the language is, so friends, in communication, language is a code. It is a verbal code. I hope you got your answer right. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, when a purpose of a definition is to explain the use or to eliminate ambiguity of the definition, it is called lexical definition. So friends, I hope you knew this. When a purpose of definition is to explain the use or to eliminate the ambiguity, the definition is called lexical definition. I hope you knew this. Moving on to the next question. A deductive argument is invalid. So friends, a deductive argument is invalid if premises are false but the conclusion is true. So remember this, the correct answer is premises are false but conclusion is true. Moving on to the next. The question is, which of the following are the characteristic features of communication? The statements are, A, communication involves exchange of ideas, facts and opinions. This is correct. B, communication involves both information and understanding. This is also correct. And C, communication is continuous process. Yes, and communication is a circular process. So this is also correct. So all the statements given here are correct. So the correct answer will be A, B, C, D. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, they have asked us, this is number series and what will be the next number. So friends, if you look at the differences from 2 to 5, it is 3, from 5 to 9, it is 4, and from 9 to 19, it is 10. But then there is no continuity. But if you look, leave one number and then you see from 2 to 9, it is 7, from 9, from 5 to 19, it is 14, and from 9 to 37, it is 28. So if you leave one number, then you will get the answer. So the next number will be 56 plus 19, so that number will be 75. If you have any doubt, you can comment in comment section. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, inductive reasoning is grounded on, so friends, inductive reasoning is grounded on uniformity of nature. Remember this. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, one day Prakash left home and walked 10 km towards south, turned right and walked 5 km, turned right and walked 10 km, and turned left and walked 10 km. How many kilometers will he have to walk to reach his home state? So friends, for you I have tried to solve this. So in this diagram you can see, from home he walks to south 10 km, then he turns right and walks 5, and then he turns right again and walks 10 kilometers. So now at this position, after this walking 10 kilometers, he is just 5 kilometers away from his home, but then he again walks for 10 kilometers further from home. So total distance will be 10 plus 5, so he will be 15 kilometers away from his home. So for him to reach his home, he should walk straight 15 kilometers. I hope you understood this. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, girl introduces a boy as son of the daughter of the father of her uncle. The boy is related to girl as, so here the daughter of uncle's father is uncle's sister, and uncle's sister is mother, right? So mother's son will be brother. So this is the family related question, family relationship related question. If you have any doubt, you can comment. The correct answer is that girl who introduced the boy as son of daughter of father of her uncle is his actually brother, is her brother. Next question is, while introducing a boy, Raju says he is the son of my wife's sister. So how is the boy related to Raju? So friends, here it is simple question, it is nephew of Raju. I hope you got your answer right. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, in certain code, Mathura is coded as JX, sorry, MATHURA is coded as JXQEROX. So friends, here if you go by ABCD, the every letter is, it is minus two letters. So M, they are, if you J K L M, So you have to reduce two and then you have to write. So that way they have asked us how hotels will be written. So hotels you have to reduce two from H, so it will be E. First letter will be E and the last letter will be P. So you just check it, because QR you can eliminate, and here E, F, G in case of H you can eliminate. So first E and last will be P. So correct answer is C. That is ELQBIP. So hotels will be written, HOTELS will be ELQBIP. I hope you got your answer correct. Moving on to the next question. The term grapevine is also known as. So friends, the grapevine communication is a communication where there is no fixed route or fixed format to communicate. So it is called informal communication. I hope you got your answer correct. The question is, formal communication tend to be a fast and flexible. So friends, here they have given one assertion, and the reason is formal communication is a systematic and orderly flow of information. So friend, the reason is correct, where formal communication is orderly and is systematic, whereas informal communication is not orderly and it is faster compared to the formal communication. So the formal communication tend to be fast and flexible. Here it is, there is definite order and you have to follow certain path in case of formal communication. So the assertion is wrong, but reason, that is formal communication is systematic and orderly flow of information, that's correct. So the correct answer is A. Assertion is false, but reason is correct. I hope you understood this. If you did not, please tell me in comment section. Moving on to the next question. Question is, micro teaching is more effective. So friends, micro teaching, if you know, it is a teacher training program where your teacher is trained for teaching. So where teacher is taught a different teaching skill. So this is during preparation for teacher practice. So this is for teaching preparation. So the correct answer is during preparation for teaching practice. I hope you understood. Moving on to the next question. Understanding theories and principle of children's learning is a fundamental importance for. So understanding theories and principle of children's learning is important for effective teaching. This is correct. For effective curriculum planning, this is also important. This is also correct. For motivation of the learner, this is also correct. So the answer will be all of the above. Moving on to the next question. Next question is the most significant approach of evaluation. So friends, most significant approach. So first is continuous and comprehensive evaluation, conductive objective term end examination, C, maintaining cumulative records of students, C, semester system evaluation. So friends, the continuous evaluation is always better, day to day or whatever, and comprehensive means by with understanding. Continuous and with understanding evaluation is the most significant approach for the evaluation. So this is correct answer. Moving on to the next question. The question is, the best way to react to a wrong answer given by a student is. So friends, the best way to react when a student gives a wrong answer is not to scold him, to ask another student to give correct answer, or not to ignore the wrong answer and pass the next question. No, these are not the best way. Best way is to explain why the answer is wrong. So this is the correct answer. Next question is, which of the following is or are basic paradigms in classroom teaching? So friends, learning paradigm and instructional paradigm are basic paradigms in classroom teaching. So answer will be both A and B. Moving on to the next question. Friends, the question is, objectivity in research implies. So friends, objectivity in research means carrying out research without a bias or judgment or prejudice. So here the objectivity means finding consistency with reality. It should not be a fake So the objectivity, I hope you understood it. Moving on to the next question. Next question is research is. Option is purposeful systematic activity conducted for purely academic purpose. No, this is not the correct. C, conducted to answer questions about practical issue. No, research is not about, yes, the science or the technology is for this, but research aim is not this. A random unplanned process of discovery. No, so research is purposeful systematic activity. Remember this, research is purposeful systematic activity. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, research can be classified as it basic, yes, applied, yes, action research, yes, quantitative and qualitative research, yes, philosophical, historical, survey and experimental research, yes, all of these. So the correct answer is research can be classified as, remember all of these, so answer is all of the above. Next question is, which of the following factor does not impact teaching? First is learning through experience, okay, teacher's knowledge, classroom activities that encourage learning, socio-economic background of teacher and student. So the socio-economic background of teacher and student does not impact teaching. I hope you got your answer right. Moving on to the next question. Question is, which of the following state has highest installed solar power capacity in India? So friends, Tamil Nadu tops the solar power capacity in India. I hope you got your answer right. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following state is highest producer of wind energy in India? So in this case too, the Tamil Nadu tops the highest producer of wind energy graph. I hope you got your answer right. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following are related to ozone, protection of ozone layer? So first is Basel Convention, Vienna Convention, Montreal Protocol. So friends, options are 2 and 3, that is Vienna Convention and Montreal Protocol are related to ozone layer depletion. So only 2 and 3 are correct. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which country is called oxygen tank of the world? So here, as we know, our neighbors Bhutan is carbon positive country, so they are called oxygen tank of the world. I hope you got your answer right. The question is, which of the following renewable energy source form leads to air pollution? Options are geothermal energy, wind energy, solar power, ocean thermal energy. So friends, the geothermal energy leads to the air pollution. Moving on to the next question. Question is, when was Environmental Protection Act implemented in India? So friends, it was implemented on 1986 on the aftermath of Bhopal gas tragedy, which was caused by the release of methyl isocyanate. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, what is the full form of COD? So friends, this is same or equivalent to BOD, where BOD stands for biological oxygen demand, whereas COD stands for chemical oxygen demand. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, Project Tiger was introduced in. So friends, Project Tiger was introduced when it was introduced by our Prime Minister, late Srimati Indira Gandhi, in 1973. I hope you got your answer right. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, World Wildlife Fund was founded in. So friends, it was founded in 1961. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, who for the first time proposed or coined the word ecosystem? So friends, it was proposed in the year 1935 by Arthur Tansley. I hope you got your answer right. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, Bhopal gas tragedy occurred due to leakage of which gas? So friends, it occurred due to leakage of methyl isocyanate. Now moving on to the next question. The question is, Earth's land surface covered by forest is about. So friends, it is about 30 to 31%. Moving on to the next question. Next question is liquefied petroleum gas, that is LPG, is a mixture of. So friends, LPG is a mixture of propane and butane. Moving on to the next question. What is the meaning of hibernate in Windows XP and Windows? So friends, if you own a laptop or you have used this option, hibernate option is like a log off or a switch off. In switch off, when you say switch off or when you say log off, all the existing open program, they close and your mobile go in the say switch off mode. But in hibernate, whatever program you are running program, they are not closed and you can shut down your computer. So the correct answer is shut down the computer without closing the running application. So the hibernate means your running program will remain as it is, but your computer will be shut down. So remember this term, hibernate. Moving on to the next question. The question is, pollutants responsible for ozone hole are, the options are A, chlorofluorocarbons, B, smog, C, sulfur dioxide, and D, none of these. So of these, C, sulfur dioxide is responsible for acid rain, and smog, as we know, is not responsible for the hole for ozone hole. It is just a normal pollutant. Now chlorofluorocarbons, a source of which is refrigerator and any cooling instrument we use. So this is responsible for ozone hole. Remember this, the answer is chlorofluorocarbons. Now moving on to the next question. The question is, which of the following is air pollution indicator? So friends, I'll tell you the answer and I'll tell you the reason why the answer is the same. So the lichen is the air pollution indicator. The reason is because lichens, when they grow, they don't take up nutrients from the soils. So they take up nutrients from the atmosphere, that is from the air. When there are less nutrient in the atmosphere, so you can conclude that air is polluted. So when there is low growth of the lichens, in that case the air is polluted. When you see highest or more growth of the lichens, you can say the air is clean and it is fertile. So I hope you have got your answer correct. Moving on to the next question. The question is, highest source of air pollution in the world is. So the correct answer of the highest contributor for the air pollution are currently industries. So industries are the highest contributor for the air pollution. I hope you have got your answer correct. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, thinner particles responsible for deteriorating the air quality are referred as particulate matter. So they have asked the size of the particulate matter which is actually responsible for the air quality deterioration. So friends, the particulate matter 2.5, these are responsible for the deteriorating air quality. I hope you got your answer right. Now moving on to the next question. The question is, biomagnification implies. So friends, the biomagnification is related to the magnification of either toxins or say pesticides higher into the higher levels of the food chain. So in this case, from the given option, the toxic matter are magnified. So this is the correct answer. Foods are not magnified, only toxic matters are magnified. And remember this, when biomagnification, it implies to magnification of the toxins, toxic matter, or say pesticides, say higher up the higher in the food level. I hope you got your answer right. Now moving on to the next question. Soil erosion can be prevented by. So this is a relatively simple question. It cannot be prevented by constructing a dam, because dam have also caused this soil erosion, and deforestation is because of deforestation there is lot of soil erosion, and afforestation like planting of plants, yes, this is the answer for afforestation is the answer for preventing the soil erosion. I hope you got your answer right. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following are or is responsible for acid rain. So as I told in the earlier questions, that sulfur dioxide is responsible, nitrogen dioxide is responsible for acid rain, because it gives, when it combines with water, it gives nitric acid. Sulfur dioxide, when it combines with water, it gives sulfur dioxide, and sulfur trioxide also combines with water to give sulfuric acid. So the correct answer is all of the above. So that is all of these. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. So next question is, algal bloom results in. So friends, algal bloom results in eutrophication. In eutrophication, the nutrient and minerals in water body increases to very high level, and the oxygen level drops down drastically. So this happens because of the highest growth of alga. So once their algal die, for their decomposition, lot of oxygen is consumed, and then the whole process is called eutrophication. So I hope you got your answer correct. The correct answer for this question is algal bloom results in eutrophication. I hope you have answered it. Question is, in water treatment, use of chloramine ensures. So friends, the chloramine is a mixture of chlorine and ammonia. So mixture of these, when added to water, it is used as disinfectant to disinfect water. So I hope you got your answer correct. So the chloramine is used to disinfect water. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following is greenhouse gas? So friends, the looking at other all the options, you can easily say that the air has a nitrogen, that is 79% oxygen, 21%, and some of it is argon. So they are not greenhouse gases. So methane is a greenhouse gas. I hope you got your answer correct. Now moving on to the next question is, which of the following is the best way to get rid of non-biodegradable waste? So the options are burning. So burning is not a solution. You may get rid of your waste, but you are creating another problem, that is air pollution. And burying and dumping are not a permanent solution. In India, mostly we use burying. Most of the municipalities in India use burying, but that is not the best solution. The best solution is recycle, and as famous in India, that is reuse. Recycle and reuse. So is the best way to get rid of non-biodegradable waste. So I hope you got your answer correct. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, which water is more capable of holding an oxygen gas? So friends, I will tell you, the at 0 degrees Celsius, 1 liter of water holds approximately 14 mg per liter of a oxygen, and at 25 degrees Celsius it holds around 8 mg per liter of the oxygen. So the cool water holds more oxygen compared to the hot water. Remember this, because this will be useful for the blood BOD, that is biological oxygen demand. So the cold water holds more oxygen than the hot water. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following is turning Taj Mahal, that is historical monument of India, yellow? So friends, the sulfur dioxide, which also causes the acid rain, that is an acid rain, as we know, that is mixture of H2SO4, that is sulfuric acid and nitric acid. So the sulfur dioxide is responsible for the turning Taj Mahal yellow. Remember this, the answer is sulfur dioxide. Moving, the question is, high biological oxygen demand indicates water is. So friends, when there is a high biological oxygen demand, means there is more consumption of the oxygen and there is less oxygen present in the water body. So the water body is polluted. So I hope you have answered this correctly. The high BOD means the water is polluted, and low BOD means water is good, or is one can say drinkable. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, Montreal Protocol is related to. So friends, the Montreal Protocol is related to the chlorofluorocarbon chemicals. So as we have seen in the earlier question that chlorofluorocarbons, they are related to ozone depletion. So the Montreal protocol is about the ozone depletion. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following waste can be turned into fertilizer? So friends, the biodegradable waste can be turned into the fertilizer, and e-waste or factory waste or non-biodegradable waste, they cannot be turned into fertilizer. So the correct answer is biodegradable waste. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, peacock is considered in which part of biotic component? So friends, the producer, so it cannot be a plants are producer, and decomposers are also, peacock can't be considered as a decomposer because the bacteria or other species can be called decomposer. The consumer, so the peacock is a consumer, it consumes the either insect or say grass. So the correct answer is peacock is consumer in the food chain. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, tsunami is caused by or caused due to. So friends, the tsunami is caused due to the undersea earthquake. Because of the undersea earthquake, there will be a rift in the sea, and to fill that rift, there will be water going into the rift, and then after coming there will be a resultant backward force, and then you will have a lot of water outside sea. So the correct answer is undersea earthquake. Now moving on to the next question. The question is, ozone is present in which layer of the atmosphere? So friends, the ozone is a triatomic oxygen which is formed via the free radical reaction of oxygen due to UV light, and it is present in the lower stratosphere. I hope you guys know this. If you did not know, now I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is about the noise, that is the noise limit in residential area. The permissible noise level in day and night time is, so friends, I will tell you, there are three types of central pollution control board has assigned three types of residential and commercial and the industrial areas. In industrial areas, the limit daytime limit is 75 decibel and night time limit is 70 decibel, and in commercial area it is 65 decibel in the day and 55 decibel in the night, and in residential area it is 55 decibel in the day and 45 decibel in the night. So remember all these three areas and their limits. Now next question is, in industrial area the permissible noise limit is. So friends, I have already told you in the last question that in industrial area the permissible noise limit in day is 75 decibel and in night it is 70 decibel, and for commercial it is 65 decibel in the day and 55 decibel in the night, and in case of residential, as we seen earlier, it is 55 decibel in the day and 45 decibel in the night. So remember all these limits. Now moving on to the next question. The next question is, which of the following is responsible for water pollution? First option is hydrocarbon, option 2 is animal waste, and option 3 is heavy metals. So friends, if you look at the option carefully, it appears that all of them are responsible for the water pollution. So all of the above is the answer. I hope you got your answer right. Moving on. The question is, pollution of water is measured by dissolved amount of. Options are A, nitrogen, 2, oxygen, and 3, methane and carbon dioxide. So friends, as we have seen earlier, biological oxygen demand, if it is higher, the water is polluted, and if biological oxygen demand is lower, then water is pure or is drinkable. So the oxygen, amount of oxygen decides where water is polluted or not. So I hope you got your answer right. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, natural source of air pollution is. So options are 1. A, flood, 2 drought, 3 earthquake and 4 volcanic eruption. So friends, the natural source of air pollution is volcanic eruption, where lot of particulate matter, as we have seen earlier, that particulate matter 2.5 is harmful for the air pollution, or is responsible for the air pollution. So the correct answer is volcanic eruption. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following waterborne disease is viral in origin? So friends, if you look at the options, typhoid is bacterial infection, cholera is bacterial infections, and shigellosis is also a bacterial infection. Only polio or poliomyelitis is caused by virus, that is poliomyelitis itself. And we know that India is almost polio free, but it is a viral origin disease. So the correct answer here is poliomyelitis. I hope you got your answer right. Moving on to the next. The question is, biotic environment includes A. producers, B. consumers, C. decomposers, and fourth is all of the above. So friends, in an ecosystem, all the living environments are biotic component, and the biotic components are producers, consumers and decomposers. So all of them are biotic component. So the correct answer is all of the above. Now next question is, ring of fire is seen at. So friends, ring of fire is a ring around the ocean where frequent earthquake or volcanic eruptions occurs. So this is located in the basin of Pacific Ocean. So I hope you got your answer correct. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, sum of all the ecosystem is classified as. So friends, sum of all the ecosystem is classified as biosphere. I hope you got your answer right. Moving on to the next question. The place of formulation of Food and Drug Organization is. So friends, it was first of formed in the Washington in 1945, but it was now it is moved to Italy in 1951. So the correct answer is 2, that is Italy, and it was moved there in 1951 and it comes under United Nations. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, eutrophication causes decrease in. So friends, we have seen it, eutrophication means there is a increase in algae, that is phytoplankton, and once they die, for their decomposition the oxygen is used, and there is eutrophication causes decrease in dissolved oxygen. So for the decomposition, lot of oxygen is being used up, so the oxygen decreases. So I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, what is dangerous for the environment? A growing plant is obviously good for environment. Increasing population is bad for environment. Growing crops is also good for environment, and growing technology is good, because even if the technology may create some problem, but it also has solution for the pollution. Now so the of the four, increasing population appears to be the good answer, or the answer. Now moving on to the next question. The question is, the part of earth where life is known as is called. So the correct answer for this question is, the part of earth where life is known is called biosphere. I hope you got this answer right. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following is the most effective way of the communication? So friends, there are in general there are four ways of communication, but they have asked us the most effective way of the communication. So options are A, non-verbal communication, B, verbal communication, C, silence, and D, written communication. So friends, the correct answer for this is most effective way of communication is verbal communication. So remember this, this is factual question, and I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is created by Mike Krieger and Kevin Systrom. This app was acquired by Facebook in April 2012. What is it? So friends, as you know that Twitter it operates independently and LinkedIn is bought by Microsoft. So there are only two options. I also want to tell you that Instagram and WhatsApp are bought by the Facebook. Now they are like they work as a subsidiary to the Facebook. Now friends, now the correct answer for this, the Mike Krieger and Kevin Systrom founded the Instagram, and that then that was acquired by the Facebook in April 2012. So remember this. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is from the number series. So they have asked us to find the one fill in the bracket. So friends, if you look at the number 6000 and 5940, then 5881, options are, as you can see, so there are options 5746, 5854, 5824 and 5823. So friends, if you look at the every number, so there is definite relation. If you subtract 5940 from 6000, so it will come 60, and if you subtract 5881 from the 5940, so it will be 59. So next number will be less by the 58. So the correct answer is 5823. I hope you have answered this correctly, and if there is any doubt, you can comment in the comment section about this number series or logical reasoning or mathematical reasoning problems. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, find the missing number in the following. So friends, if you see the there is a one definite trend from if you move down from say 147, so it is 27. If you move down the column, then 258, 38. So there is no definite trend, but you 369. So what will be the number? So here, if you just see, this is multiplication of the. If you look across the column first, 4 multiplied by 7, it will be 28 minus 1 will be 27. And if you look at second column, then 5 into 8, it will be 40 minus 2 will be 38. So likewise, if 6 into 9, it will be 54 minus 3, and the correct answer will be 51. I hope you have answered this correctly. If there is any doubt, you can comment in the comment section. Moving on to the next.
The question is, government agency responsible for collection of various types of data in India is CSO. So friends, CSO stands for, the options are A, Central Statistical Organization, B, Central Statistics Office, and Central Staff Organization, D, Central Staff Office. So friends, CSO, as you know, that many data they release, like the very recently released employment data, the full form of the CSO is B, Central Statistics Office. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, HTML stands for.
So friends, HTML, the options are hypertext makeup language, hypertext marketing language, and hypertext marked language, and D is hypertext markup language. So the correct answer for this question is hypertext markup language, that is option D. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question.
The question is, find out the next term in the following series. So friends, I have also included the mathematical reasoning questions in this mock test, so you'll have more such questions. Now coming to this question, where the number series is 0, 3, 8, 15, 24. So this is a simple question to begin with. If you just take out the differences between the adjacent number, so it is in the 0 and 3 it is 3, and from 3 to 8 it is 5, and from 8 to 15 it is 7, and from 15 to 24 it is 9. Now the next number difference should be 11, so if you add 11 to 24, it will be a 35. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Moving on to the next question is, effective learning means. So options are modification in behaviors of learner, B, consistency in behavior of learner, C, to recall information by the learner, and C, D is good performance of the learner in the examination. So friends, the correct answer for this question is modification in the behavior of the learner. So the effective learning means modification in the behavior of the learner. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, the content of communication is called. The options are A. Message, B. Noise, C. Channel, D. Distortion. So friends, correct answer for this question is the content of communication is called message. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, who is better teacher? Options are, the one who strictly follows the disciplinary guidelines, the one who devotes full time to school, and the one who is interested in overall development of his students. And option D is one who develops quality leadership in students. So friends, the correct answer for this question is the one who is interested in overall development of the students. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, identify the unethical practice of the researchers from the following. So these questions are from research aptitude. So the unethical practice is, options are avoiding plagiarism. So you should avoid plagiarism. This is ethical practice. B, avoiding duplication. This is also an ethical practice. You should avoid duplication. And avoiding manipulation. Option D is also an ethical practice. You should avoid manipulation. So the unethical practice here is avoiding the reliable data. Avoiding the reliable information is an unethical practice. So friends, I hope you have answered this correctly. The answer is C, avoiding reliable information is an unethical practice. Now moving on to the next question.
What is MP3? So friends, we generally use MP4 is a video format, MP3 is a sound format. So I hope you know this. Now moving on to the next question. What is the meaning of hibernate in Windows XP and Windows? So friends, if you own a laptop or you have used this option, hibernate option is like a log off or a switch off. In switch off, when you say switch off or when you say log off, all the existing open program, they close and your mobile go in the switch off mode. But in hibernate, whatever program you are running program, they are not closed and you can shut down your computer. So the correct answer is shut down the computer without closing the running application. So the hibernate means your running program will remain as it is, but your computer will be shut down. So remember this term, hibernate. Moving on to the next question. TCP/IP is necessary if one has to connect to the. So friends, TCP/IP is transmission control protocol and internet protocol. Its long form is transmission control protocol and internet protocol, and it is necessary for connecting to the internet. So remember this, it is necessary. TCP and IP is necessary for connecting to the internet. Remember this term, TCP is transmission control protocol and IP protocol, so that is internet protocol. Moving on to the next question. The file extension of MS Word document in Office The question is, which process permits multiple computers to use the same IP address and hide their actual IP address from the internet? So friends, this is very interesting question where they have asked which process allows you to use the duplicate IP address. So remember this, network address translation, that is NAT. By NAT you can use multiple computers can use same IP address by hiding their actual IP address. So remember this, NAT. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following is interactive media? So friends, radio broadcast is one way communication. A talk show on TV, it talk show, their people talk, but for us as a media, it is one way media, not interactive media, because TV also is mass media and newspaper also is a mass media, is one way media, and computer game is interactive media where some games you interact with the other players and in some games you interact with the computer. So the correct answer for this question is computer game. Moving on to the next question. To what temporary area can you store a text and other data and later paste them into the other another location in the computer? So friends, if you have used this option, the copy to the clipboard, then you can copy it and paste at the desired location. So the clipboard is a temporary area where you can store the text and other data and later paste them to the another location which you are desired. So I hope you knew this. Moving on to the thank you friends, thank you for watching this episode. I hope you have enjoyed it. If you have enjoyed it, please subscribe and share with your friends. Thank you.